Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This video series deals with working on various CGI render passes in Autodesk Smoke. Hopefully from the previous video, you have a better understanding on how to manage different color spaces in Smoke. All our elements are now in scene linear color space. We also have a photo map color transform applied to the viewer to correctly display the colors. Let's start building the composite. Go to the media library and click and drag the divide bar to widen the view. Click and drag at the top of the name column to expand out all the render pass names. Hold Command and select the ABGR render pass and the ABGR alpha render pass. Drag them into the Connect Effect schematic. These passes are all the CGI components rendered together. You could call this a combined beauty pass. To composite the background and render passes together, hover over the node bin and press B for Blend and Comp. Drag out the Blend and Comp node and place it next to the source clip nodes. Now take the output from the fill node and connect that into the first red front input of the Blend and Comp node. Now take the output from the alpha node and connect that into the first blue alpha input of the Blend and Comp node. Finally, take the output of the background node and connect that into the green background input of the Blend and Comp node. So clicking on the Blend and Comp node shows the combined result. However, the CGI smoke is too bright. Scrubbing through the frames, the CGI smoke should have much more detail than this. So we will use a color correction to darken the smoke. Clicking on the ABGR fill node, you can see that the source was pre-multiplied with its alpha. This will present problems when color correcting the fill, especially the transparent edges. To correct this, you need to unpre-multiply the fill before color correcting. Please check out my series on dealing with alpha in smoke to go through all these alpha issues in detail. Click the Effects Node button to ensure you have the Connect Effects nodes and press L for the Logic Op node. Drag out the Logic Op node and drop it into the connection after the fill. Connect the output of the alpha into the green back input of the Logic Op node. Double-click on the Logic Op node to bring up its menus. Change the blend mode setting from Add to Divide. You can see that the source has been divided by its alpha, giving you all the true colors in its edges. If I bypass the Logic Op node, you can see the before and after this unpre-multiplied operation. Switch back to the Connect Effects node bin via the Effects node button. Hover over the node bin and press C for color correction. Drag out a color correct node and drop it in after the Logic Op node. Double click on the color correct node for its menus. Now drop the RGB gain slider down to a value of 10. Because this is a 16-bit float file, there is so much color information in the OpenEXR. This allows you to recover detail you thought you might have lost in the render pass during the rendering process. So scrubbing the time bar again, you will see that there is loads of detail in the smoke. Double-click on the Blend and Comp node to see the composited result. Now that the composite has started to take shape, we can start tweaking all aspects. First, let's say we want to defocus the background a little bit more. Click on the Effects Node button to return to the Node bin and press B for Blur. Drag out the Blur node and drop it after the LUT editor in the Background branch. Now I would like to monitor my results in the Blend and Comp node when I adjust the Blur node. To do this, you can use the context view. Hold the dash keyboard shortcut and click on the Blend and Comp node. You will see a C1 appear under the node specifying a contextual point in the node tree. Hover over the result view and press Ctrl 1 to bring up the Context 1 viewer. So now if you double-click on the blur node, you will always see everything upstream in the node tree. Now let's change the blur type from Gaussian to defocus. Set the blur width and height to a value of 5. You can now see how the contextual view will update. You can play around with other settings like bokeh blur, etc., but you get the general gist. At any point, if you wish to see the result coming out of the currently selected node, hover over the context viewer and press F4 for the result viewer. To remove the context viewer off the blend and comp node, hold the dash keyboard shortcut and click on the node. Now taking a step back and looking at the overall composite so far, we have blurred the background and darkened the CGI smoke to bring out the detail. However, in doing so, we have also darkened the robot and the football. So in order to control each render element, it is better to return back to the render passes and work with each part separately. So in the media library, you will see a beauty pass for the ball and a beauty pass for the robot. Each one has their respective alphas. However, the CGI smoke was never rendered as a separate render pass. This is not a problem. We have enough information from all the render passes to break the CGI render down further and isolate the CGI smoke. In the next video, we will use a few clever compositing techniques to separate the CGI smoke from the robot and the football. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.